Hi, Nayab and Mikal. Thank you so much for coming in today. How are you guys?
I'm very well, thank you. Good to be here.
I actually think you brought the good weather along with you because a few days ago it was so hot. Yeah. Like there was a heat wave and then you came and it's
and
like
it's raining.
Nice well, and cool. Yeah, today's raining
Mikal
actually.
Mikal means barish barsane wala. So.
Does it really yeah, rain? Does, so. Oh, how interesting.
Rainmaker.
How many days have you been here for?
It's been about 3 or 4 days, I think.
Have you done any like touristy things?
Not really because I've
Well, you went to the Toronto sign.
Well, okay. Yeah. I've spent a lot of time in Toronto before, yeah. So I mean, you know, kind yeah. of done touristy
but
things.
But you went to the Blue Jays game. Recently,
I went to the Blue Jays game, which was good. Yeah. This is something I wanted to do last time.
Have you ever been?
Yeah.
So I've been living here my entire life. I've never gone. No.
It's so fun.
I know.
I love watching games. I think games are, you know, it's great entertainment.
Yeah.
You have a lot of fun, you know. If you get into the spirit of the game, it's
I know.
A lot of fun.
See, I've lived here my entire life, but it's one of those things where you're like, I'll eventually go, but if you live here, so you would never get to go.
Yeah.
So I saw
yeah,
you
true.
There, I was
that's
like,
true, yeah.
I should go.
Well, it was only across the road, so.
Oh, right. Okay, so it's convenient for you. And you and Harim went, right?
Me and Harim went, yeah. We just got back from rehearsals and we'd missed half the game already. So anyway, I was like, yeah, do you want to go? And she was game. So I was like, come on, let's go.
Oh, so you want like last minute tickets?
Yeah. Okay. So we got
did
nice
they
seats.
Win?
And stuff.
Yeah, they
did
they
win.
Yeah. Okay,
and it was
luck.
Like a crunch game because they went to the 10th innings, like a tiebreaker kind of a thing. Yeah. So yeah, it was fun.
So you're here for the Hum TV Awards.
Yep.
How's that been for you so far?
Good. I mean, we're rehearsing right now. And I mean, I've been a part of Hum TV since it started. So this is the 6th award.
Yeah.
You know, and we're doing. And I'm usually in some form or the other, either hosting it or perform. This is the first time I'm performing, so.
Oh, are you nervous?
Yes and no. I mean, you know.
With dance, I feel like I know Amna Sheikh was here like a couple of weeks ago, and she was saying she was performing in I don't know what award show, but she's like I blanked out. Like she went on stage and it was live and being shown with like a crowd.
Wow,
so I wonder if that's like a concern for you. Like
I hope not. No. Yeah, don't put things like that in my head.
Okay, no.
Was not concerned about it till now.
No, because when I heard her say it, I was like, oh, that's a thing. I didn't know artists could just like.
I mean, I've been blanked out on stage while hosting a show, which is like.
Oh. Okay.
So yeah, but you know, I think.
Dance is more rehearsed, so maybe you'll
over a period of time, you learn how to cover up as well. So.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Especially with hosting too, you could just like crack a joke or say something, and then.
In fact, you know, I think you know what I've learned in this business is whatever you do, do it with confidence.
Yeah,
you know,
for
even
sure.
if you're wrong, you know, it'll sound right.
So. That's true. Actually, it's funny. Someone asked me like a question one time, and I don't know the answer. And they were like, "You could have said any number, and I would have believed you, right?
Yeah, yeah.
As long as you're making it seem like you know what you're talking about, fake it until you make
there
it.
We go. Yeah. There you go.
Now your movie just
fake
came
it
out.
Even once you've made it.
Yeah, is that what you're still doing?
Yeah, of course.
That's like good advice for Nayal.
Thanks.
But yeah, your movie just came out. How has the response been for that, like you two so far?
It's been good. You know, it's been decent. I mean, you know, I think we were slightly unfortunate with the release because there was a lot of competition and we didn't get the same screen time that other films did. So in terms of business, it hasn't reflected very well. But you know, the film has been good overall.
Good feedback from everyone.
It was good experience.
It was really good for me because I got a lot of exposure and I've already signed up my next project.
You have?
Yeah.
Oh, what are you doing next?
So I can't really talk about it.
Okay, tell me what you can tell me.
But it's a movie.
Nice.
So
okay.
I'm excited for it. I just got the script. I'm just looking at
when do you start filming? Do you know?
End of August.
Okay,
yeah.
And in
so
Pakistan?
Pretty soon. No.
Oh, okay. Okay, I want to. Okay, that's awesome. So we'll see you again on the big screen. Oh, you said it's a movie, right?
Yeah, it's a movie.
Okay,
yeah.
That's awesome. Now you like what she told me was you've been like a mentor to her. She was asking you questions, like texting you. How does that feel? Because it's like a newcomer. Yeah. You guys became friends so quickly. Like, how has your relationship evolved?
Well, you know, I mean, I've worked with a lot of. I've been a newcomer myself, of course, and then I've worked with a lot of newcomers. And you know, I mean, whether it was Nayab and me got along really well, and you know, she's got good work ethic and wanted to learn, and you know. So, you know, I mean, it was easy to, you know, pass it on. But whenever I'm working with new people, I mean, I feel a sense of responsibility.
Oh,
you
that's
know,
nice.
In a way.
Yeah. You're
and whoever that is. I mean, sometimes it's, you know, I don't like to interfere too much either. You know, because I don't like being told either.
It can backfire, right? Sometimes
I mean, you don't want to go too overboard, you know. But I see. You know, I think there's a certain sense of duty, you know, in doing that.
For sure.
And whoever it is, I mean, whatever, you know, whether it was Nayab or anyone, even if it's just one scene, you know, you need to be comfortable with each other to, you know, obviously depending on what the nature of the scene is. But so a friendly atmosphere always kind of works.
And yours specifically was like a love intro, so you had to.
Well, exactly.
That
yeah.
You had to
But I did, you know. The first day I met, we got on. Yeah. Got on like, yeah. from day one.
Yeah, so. And I mentioned I watched the film and like seen you two. You there was chemistry.
Yeah,
like,
there was. Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah. I like.
No,
I
we're
like,
good we know. Friends. We're close friends. Yeah. So yeah. It was fun.
Yeah, it was nice. What was your first impression of each other? Yeah, you tell me first. Let's hear yours first.
So I was told that he's like the biggest star in Pakistan. So I was expecting this douchebag. So I went to his hotel and they made me dress up, okay? Like I'm wearing heels and like dress and like super dolled up. And I go to his like whatever I went to meet him. He had just woken up. He's in his PJs and he's like, "Hey, what's up?" So he was super normal. I felt so stupid.
All like dressed up. You're all like head to toe.
Yeah, the first meeting that we had was in my room. Because I just come in from the flight.
Your perspective on this.
Yeah, yeah. So I was just, you know, I was also a little conscious, you know, whenever you're meeting, you know, anyone for the first time, and I was meeting a whole team.
Right.
You know, in which Naya was there, Angelica was there, our director was there, Cheyenne, and the Lord. You know, so I had just woken up from a long flight, so I was like, you know, t-shirt, you know, but I was like, hey, you know, come on in, you know, Chapman, and all of these people are dressed up, so it was, you know, it was a bit awkward for me as well, but.
But Naya specifically, where you're like, oh, she seems nice.
Yeah, I liked her. I thought, you know, she seemed really sweet, you know, and she, you know, she, you know, she has a really nice and, you know, appealing personality. So
yeah, she's very bubbly and like.
She is.
Yes. Yeah. I've noticed that too.
She's with a very. You know, she's very friendly.
Yeah, for sure.
It's very easy to get along with her.
Yeah, I think that's why I've like kept in touch with Nayab over the years, because she's like she's just grown in like a good way. She hasn't like changed
that's
in like
true.
A negative way.
That's true.
I'm
that's
sure
true.
You'll come to realize in the next like few years too.
Yeah,
like,
maybe. Yeah.
Just gets better.
Oh, that's so sweet. Thank you. This is the Nayab show.
She gets better with age, huh?
Yeah. So what was like? What was the first thing you two said to each other? Like, do you remember that?
I don't remember.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, yeah. We were like super cool. We're like, hey, what's up?
Just like a casual.
I remember when we did lines though. Remember the first day on the shoot? It wasn't our scene, but you were like, let's do some lines.
Yeah.
And then I had my own thing memorized, but then he told me, okay, why didn't you say it like this? And then that, so he was helping me from day one.
Yeah.
Even when we weren't shooting yet.
Yeah, as in, I mean, as I said, you know, with, you know, especially with a love interest in a project, you know, you want to get comfortable with the person. So I think, you know, we got chatty. I started showing a lot of my work and, you know, then.
I saw all his commercials. And I was laughing. I was like, oh my God, I love these.
Yeah, I hadn't seen his work. That's the first thing that I have seen. The UFON one. And I remember, like, I just, like, passed by the TV one day and it was on and it was funny at that time. I don't even think I knew who you were, but just the commercial itself was, like, a really. Yeah. Was that, like, at your early days or, like, I don't. When was
Well,
that
yeah, I was I was a part of that campaign for a long time.
Okay.
I endorsed UFON for 7 or 8 years.
Oh, wow. So it went on for all
That's a which, long time.
Yeah, we did more than 100 commercials.
So I don't know which one I saw then.
I know.
There's a ton.
There's a lot there. So then you, like, the film had a lot of newcomers, and I think all the main roles were newcomers. Was there any risk involved for you?
Well, there was, there was, naturally, you know, because, you know, newcomers are newcomers, you know, so it takes time to gel in, I mean, for everyone.
Did you have to get convinced, or you were like, you read the script, what was your thought process?
No, I mean, yeah, I liked the script, you know, and yeah, there was a slight risk, but, you know. You know, as I said, I mean, I've always supported newcomers in a way as well, and you know, I feel our industry needs new people as well. So yeah, I mean, you know, it was kind of 50-50.
Yeah.
You
know? Okay.
And I think it worked out okay in the end.
Yeah. So know, I was gonna ask that, like, do you regret it? Because obviously, once something is done, obviously, for this is your first film, so I'm like, you're happy you were in it. But for you, like, you've done a lot of dramas and films. Has there ever been a time where you look back after it was done and you're like, why did I even do that? Like, why did I sign
for
it?
No. You know, I mean, work is work. You know, I mean, for me, you know, this is my day job.
Right.
You know, this is a job for me.
No.
I mean, I have to be busy all the time. You know. So, yeah, there's stuff, you know, some stuff is amazing, some isn't, you know, but you never know, you know, that's the thing with this business. So, you know, something that you think might be amazing might not work out, and something that you think is just, like, fine might really be amazing.
Yeah, amazing. So, you never know with, like, the audience and the critics and stuff,
you know,
right?
I never regret anything I've done, you know.
Oh, because that's a good way to look at it.
I mean, wherever, you know, some people will like some stuff, some people like, you know, other stuff, you know.
Everyone's always going, like, there's always going to be people who you're not going to please, right?
Yeah, that's fine. And I think, you know, it's important to provide a wide variety of work.
For sure,
And I like to keep myself versatile, so, you know.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, I'm proud of everything I've done, and in some way or the other, it's, you know, I met some great friends, you know, and had a great time while we were shooting. You know, I was in Toronto, in
Canada.
Yeah,
it was beautiful.
About 2.5 months, yeah. You know. So we were, you know, we had a great time. I mean, I have no regrets whatsoever.
Okay, that's good to know. For you, you went back. I remember, so you were on the show like the day before you were flying to Pakistan. Yeah. And I remember us talking and you were like, I don't know what to expect. And this was this is her first interview. So like, she got practice for all the million others in Pakistan. But how was the response for you? Because you met people physically face to face and it's like probably something you have like not, you've experienced it, but on a smaller scale, right? Yeah. So how was that?
I wouldn't say I have ever experienced anything like it because we were shooting like 3 different shows in a day, going from city to city. We're doing so many promotions, going to malls and everything. So it was a really good response. I think that people were really looking forward to the movie. Everybody liked me.
That's the best part.
So I had so much fun.
You looked great in the movie.
Oh, thank you so much.
When you first came on screen, I was like, she looks really good.
Thank you.
Were you overwhelmed?
I was, for sure, because I felt like it was a lot happening at the same time in a short period of time. So I was, and but then I feel like this whole team was like a family, basically, because Cheyenne's mom was there, Cheyenne, McCall, Ali. So everybody was like a family, so I didn't feel like I'm so far away from home.
Right.
Because they were so nice and supportive of everything.
Yeah. Now your Urdu probably got better, too.
Oh, yeah, I think so, right? We were just talking about that.
Oh, really?
Right?
Okay, we're going to test that. I have a game for you after. But, you know, I think it builds your confidence, too, especially you as a newcomer, seeing, like, all these people and, like, it's fans and people trying to take selfies with you and pictures. Yeah. You're like, you know, you did something good, right? This is what you want to do. And now that you're signing a future project, I'm sure it's just going to get, like, bigger and bigger. Mm-hmm. Are you looking forward to that?
I am looking forward to it. It's nice to be, like, appreciated, for sure, like, once you do something that you love. And I think I'm really blessed to be able to do something that I really enjoy doing. So I'm really looking forward to it.
Yeah, now that you guys, like, obviously you've been meeting fans for years, for you it's like a new experience, but obviously it's been like blown up in your face, sort of. Do you guys have any horror fan stories, like, anytime
soon? McCall does.
Yeah, okay, let's hear them.
You know that one?
I'd like to share, I'd actually should like to share a nice horror
Okay, fine. Story. Let's do like a nice one and like a weird one. Yeah.
So I was actually in Houston about 2 months ago, and there was this... you know, auntie, elderly lady who's been a big fan, and she used to message me while I was, I don't know, you know, how she got in touch, but, you know, she used to message or bahut sari duaein bhejti thi, and she'd be like, you know, I love your work and you're just like a son and this and that and this and that. And she found out I'm in Houston, so she messaged me like, it'd be, you know, I really want to see you.
Like texted you on your phone?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
On my number. So anyways, I was like, you know, and she's been really sweet over the years. So I was like, sure, you know, why don't you come over where I'm staying? And, you know, so she came over with her daughter. And the moment she saw me, she kind of leapt, you know, and she hugged me and she started crying.
Oh.
Like she started bawling with tears, you know.
Yeah.
And then she didn't stop for like 5 minutes.
Wow.
You know, and she kept on like hugging me. So I was consoling her.
Yeah.
I was like, you know, I was like, I'm here. And so then her daughter was there and she was funny and she was like, गाड़ी में तो आप बोल रही थी कि आप जाके मैं ये उसको बताऊंगी मैं उसको ये बताऊंगी मैं उसको ये बताऊंगी now you're not saying anything so you know that was sweet you know
like someone loves you that much that
you know and they don't you know I've never known her you know
for sure.
never you know and you know she seemed like a very decent you know like a you know one of our Pakistani aunties you know so
I just imagined this in my head
she was just really sweet
yeah.
you know so I mean, one of the nicest things about the job is the appreciation you get.
For sure.
I mean, no matter what you do in life, you know, if someone comes up to you and say, oh, I love you or I love what you did.
Yes.
It's a great feeling.
Yeah, you know. For sure. Let's get to the weird one now.
Well,
any, like, weird or creepy, one. Like...
The girl.
I've said it enough, though. I don't think I want to talk. I gave her too much importance.
She hasn't heard it.
I haven't heard it.
Much,
let's
no,
hear
but
it.
I don't want to give her too much importance.
Oh, it's
importance,
the same girl you're talking about.
No, that's someone else.
Okay. She knows that you're talking
probably, I mean,
about
there's been 3 or 4 interviews. I mean, there's tons, you know, a lot of people
you
are,
one.
You know, a lot of, now because of social media, you know, there's so many fan pages and,
right.
you know, I mean, you know, some of them post so much, you know, about your work that I go to some of their sites to see some of my work.
For sure, like pictures and stuff, right?
Yeah.
People have came in and they've been like, oh, sometimes we get pictures of ourselves from other fan pages
yeah,
and
exactly.
then we'll repost
them, yeah, that's
right?
what I do,
that's
yeah, so that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
So, you know, I mean, again, I mean, not any, I mean, you know, crazy in the sense that, you know, people... really follow you to the extent where, you know, they love you.
Yeah.
You know, you're like a, you know, you're their idol. You're the person that they look up to. That's a lot of pressure as well.
How is it in Pakistan? Do people follow you around? Like, how is the celebrity culture in Pakistan?
Yeah, I mean, you know, if you're at a busy public place, then, you know, you could, you know, people could follow you around. They come and want selfies, you know.
Okay. Yeah. So, is it like the crazy, like, so when I see like the Bollywood one, that's like intense. Like, it's like you can't walk.
It depends on where you are.
Things,
for sure.
Yeah, sometimes. Yeah. And it depends on what event. Like, if you're there at an event where people are there to see you, they'll be crazy. You know, they'll be grabbing you, they'll be pulling you, you know.
Really? Okay.
I mean, if you're just out, you know, maybe you won't get that kind of attention, you know, just
people
normally.
People will be pointing, though. Like, I've seen people.
I mean, they'll come up. And people are polite as well. They're,
yeah, I can
but
imagine.
But the fan culture in India is like, I have bigger fans in India, I think.
Really?
You know, who are, because the thing with India is that there's a huge Muslim population over there.
Yeah.
And they have no, you know, TV or film which is catered to the Muslim audience. Mm-hmm. So the Muslim audience in India really like the Pakistani stuff
films, yeah.
and the Pakistani stars because we're Muslim as well.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, so like in India, ki jo fans hote hain wo zyada waise bhi crazy hote hain.
I've seen
I've experienced that in India.
Because it's
well.
In their culture a lot.
Yeah, like like the film industry, like they're really involved in it, right?
Exactly, exactly. Where in Pakistan, it's still growing, and that whole
it just
you know,
started. Yeah.
I feel like it's gonna get bigger. I feel like it will come to a point for a lot of celebrities.
No, it's already huge.
I'm sure. It is, but I mean internationally, like I feel like a couple of years ago there were some stars that could have gone places and other places and not gotten recognized. Now it's like I'm sure.
Yeah, I mean now
to
anywhere, even Canada. I mean,
I'm sure you're getting recognized.
You know, we got free taxi rides.
Yeah.
Oh,
you know,
and the taxi ride is free.
I'm going home with you guys. Okay. Yeah, tell me about your fan story.
We were doing promotions. I think it was in Lahore. We were at the mall, and these guys are busy like taking because it was all barred up. And then these guys are busy taking pictures, and Cheyenne said, I'll get 5 people to jump in and take pictures with us. So he calls like 10 people, and this one guy just jumps in, and you guys were busy, and he's like grabbing my hand, and 6 security guys come and pull him off, and they're like really being aggressive. Yeah. So I'm like, it's okay, leave him, he just wants a picture, I'll get a picture with him, it's okay. So anyways, he's like, yeah, she said leave me, so whatever. He comes up to me, and then he's like, acha, apne phone se leke, can you just send me on WhatsApp? And I was like, what?
That's smart.
And he kept saying it, like, come on, just do it, WhatsApp. So I thought that was, I was like, okay, bye.
I wonder if I wonder if he thought you were new, so you're like, give him your number or something. Like, maybe she doesn't know how it works.
I don't know what was going on in his head, but like, I just walked away. I was like, okay, just
so did he get a picture with you?
No, I walked away.
Okay, that's his fault then.
I know.
He pushed it. You know, for you as a newcomer, I want to know what the best advice Mikal gave you was throughout shooting or even after your friendship in general. Do you, something stand out to you that you were like, you know, I will really remember this for like the rest of my career?
This should be interesting.
Actually, he gives me advice every time I speak to him about anything and any little thing, project I've done.
Main bataun best advice.
Haan, tum bata do.
Baal bana lo
yaar. Baal bana lo yaar. Honestly,
I keep telling her to blow dry her hair.
He wants me to fix my hair. Even today when I met up with him, I'm like, okay, we're going to interview. He's like this. He's like, baal to bana leti. That's probably the best.
I just constantly tell her to, you know, big it up.
He wants me to be more glam. You know what I mean? Like, that's his advice.
So that's good advice, right?
It is.
I mean,
I'll never forget baal to bana. I finally got a blow dry, and I was like, my mom. I was telling my mom, Mikal's gonna be really happy about my blow dry.
Are you like conscious about your hair? Is that why?
Hair for me is a big thing.
Yeah, he thinks hair is everything.
That's why it's like so. It looks like it's like glued on. It looks very nice.
It's not. Today I'm actually having a bad hair day.
This is a bad hair day?
Yeah. This is a bad hair day.
Okay, so I see your standards are very high. So Ab is going to have to work.
Perfectionist.
Okay.
He is a perfectionist for sure. Okay, yeah, so even work-wise, I'll be like, I did my best performance. Like, yeah, it was great, but I think you should do this. He's very critical.
And I think that's why you've gotten so far too, because you're always trying to perfect your work.
Yeah, you know. I mean, you know, if you want to be the best or try to be, or at least be the best you can be. And I think that's what one should do. You should try and be, then you should always try and excel, and you know there's always room for improvement. I mean, I still have a long way to go. I mean, that's how I feel, although I've already alhamdulillah achieved much, or maybe people think so, or maybe, you know.
No, you have for sure. So, and I think that your positive attitude is probably what got you places,
perhaps, you know. And hard work, you know, it's
for
a lot
sure
of hard work, you know.
But you were also a newcomer once, do you remember that?
Of course I mean, you know, and I you know, with all a lot of newcomers, what I, you know, I tell them what I went through, you know.
Exactly.
And I was very hardworking. I was very go-getting, you know. You know, I wasn't shy. You know, I wasn't like, oh, main uske paas nahi ja sakta, ya main ye nahi kar sakta. I used to go and, you know, I'd speak to anyone. I would like, you know, I'm really interested in working, and, you know,
Making new friends, connections.
You know, and that's really, you know, a lot of this business is right.
She's like, new advice.
You know, he's always encouraging me all the time. And I'm like, it's okay. Like, I'm very timid, I think, in that sense. I'm not like that. Like,
and a lot of that, actually, because I'd go and meet people. So a lot of this business, a lot of life is right place at the right time.
For sure.
So in my early career, because I was everywhere, I was at the right place at the right time.
Yeah.
I mean, that's great advice.
You started off in modeling, though, right? Tell me, like, a bit of your, like, career journey. So you were born in England. Right.
I was born in England, okay. And I spent, you know, my early childhood up until 20, about half and half in England and in Pakistan. Okay. And then about 18, just after my A-levels, 18, 19, I started working.
Okay. How did you even, like, get into the industry? Did you know someone or?
No, actually someone kind of recommended me.
Okay.
To model. And I was, in fact...
he did that song with Abrarahak.
I discovered...
I was gonna my favorite song. I was going to say, so I have watched that video probably
and I didn't know
a bajillion times. It was, yeah, Abrarahak was my favorite artist.
So that was one of the first
artist.
Things I did. Yeah. It wasn't the first thing, but one of the first things I did.
It wasn't the first one.
Yeah, I guess the quality on that is also not very good. So if you, like, watch it online somewhere...
It's, yeah. It's,
no, I mean the video quality.
2002 or 3.
You have good quality for that.
No, I mean, in fact, we shot it on a, you know, this was the time when they used to have video cassettes and cameras.
Yeah.
You know? So it was still the film, you know. So
that's
it was just the end of that era, actually. So that's when I started. Yeah. You know?
And you look like a different person, too. Like,
well,
the way
I mean,
you're
I was 18, I was 18 or 19. You know,
I don't mean your looks, just like the way you're acting, obviously. I could, like, it's just like you look like it's so. Obviously, you do some very serious drama. So
well, I mean, I was,
like,
you know,
this was more
I'm
fun.
I'm older and mature, you know, for the better, I hope.
Like, jumping around and stuff.
I was a kid then. I was 18, 19, you know.
I was looking at your dancing skills. I was always a good dancer.
I was a better dancer.
He's a really good dancer, by the way.
Okay. That makes me look forward to your Humpty.
Yeah, for sure. He's really good.
I hope so.
Yeah. So then how did you go from modeling to acting? What was that transition?
Well, actually, even in the modeling, I used to do, you know, it was always more acting based. I used to do a lot of commercials. I used to do music videos, you know, which is more performance based. And actually, in fact, even before that modeling, I'd done some amateur theater. Which was kind of I'd call it semi-professional, actually. Semi-professional theater. So I'd done like 2 or 3 plays. So I was always into, you know, I enjoyed singing. You know,
really,
I actually wanted to be a singer.
No way. Okay, you're going to have to sing a little bit of something for us.
But, you know, I just, you know, I guess life had something
so
else.
So you had, like, okay, clearly you're very talented because you modeled, you know how to act.
And I never really wanted to do this. I mean, I think, I mean, I was always better at extracurricular activities rather than the curricular ones.
An actual grade.
I wasn't bad at maths. I was good at maths, but then,
That's what they all say. Yeah. No one's going to check your report.
No, I wasn't bad at maths. Okay. Everything else, but I'm not a books guy,
Which is good. I mean, there are a lot of people like...
I was into sports. I was, part of the football team and the basketball team and the cricket team and the rugby team and the hockey team and, you know, you name it.
Yeah.
I played tennis, you know. Just horse riding is what I didn't do, you know. But I did everything else, you know.
What was your ultimate goal, though? Like, when you were 18 years old, what did you want to do in 10 years?
18? I don't know. I don't think I'd ever, you know, I never had a... This is what I want to do.
Just like go with the flow.
Yeah, it was more like, you know, I mean, I would have been fine with, you know, I think if I wasn't doing this, maybe I'd be in like a corporate job or something.
Really?
You know?
Okay, but I can't imagine you in a corporate job like 9 to 5.
Well, no, I don't mind it. I mean, you know.
Okay, with someone who's so talented, I feel like it's good that you shared it with the world.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to need you to sing something for us. This is totally off script. If you wanted to be a singer, I'm sure it means that you're good.
Yes.
So like if you sing a few lines of anything for us.
Come on, sing something.
Okay, we'll come back, maybe towards
okay,
the end.
Fine.
Let me think of
something.
Think
of something and then we'll come. Sure. I'm going to remember this in case you don't forget. So 2 weeks ago, you both were also in New York for the Pakistan Film Festival, right? And there were some like really big names there. Mara Khan was there, Mehmish Hayat, I think, was there, Aisha. So how was that like, and how did you two feel being in an outside country, but seeing that Pakistani film was getting so much recognition and it's like evolving and prospering like really rapidly, I would say.
Yeah, me.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I was really happy for Pakistan, but I was also really happy for myself to be
for
there.
Yourself, yeah.
I feel like it was all the superstars of Pakistan, and then there was me. So I was really grateful, and I'm so happy that Pakistan is not just limited to Pakistan anymore, you know? In New York, and we were at the UN. We got an award.
Oh, really?
So,
you guys got an award? So it's your first award.
Yeah, so
congratulations.
That's awesome. It was great.
Yeah.
I had so much fun. Yeah.
Yeah. How was it for you? Because I know you have been involved in things like this before.
Yeah,
but
well, I mean, you know, it was a very proud moment for Pakistan, I think. And, you know, it was a great experience going to the UN. Mm-hmm. You know,
that is an honor.
Yeah, right? Yeah, and so being guests, and you know, we went up on the podium and everything, yeah. And we got a special tour.
Audience and like congresswoman.
And you know, we met several different ambassadors, and you know, it was great. And the film festival itself, you know, I mean, great effort by the Pakistani High Commission here, the UN, the mission at the UN, and Dr. Malia Lodhi. I mean, they were, you know, as you said, you know, it was the right representation for Pakistan. And this is the kind of image we need. I mean, you know, events like this, you know, Pakistan, unfortunately, in the international eyes, although it's been a lot better, and you know, can't take all of the credit. Obviously, our government and our organizations, as such, and people like Dr. Malia Lodhi, they you know, represent us in the best manner possible. But culture, you know, and film and TV, I mean, this is what really gives people a different impression, you know. And, exactly. And a lot of people, that was their reaction, like looking at Mayra, looking at Mehvish, looking at Aisha, they were like, wow, these are Pakistani actresses.
Right, yeah.
I mean, and the ambassadors were like, you know, just drooling over them, because they are, they're beautiful, you know.
Yeah, for sure.
And they're stunning, and they know how to carry themselves, mm-hmm. and, you know, so, I mean, it was the right representation of Pakistan.
I totally agree, because I feel like when a lot of people think of Pakistan, they hear, like, some of, like, they think of the bad stuff.
So we need more of this. We need more of this. You know, as much of this as possible to, you know, tell people how prosperous Pakistan is, what kind of people we have. You know, we have very educated, enlightened people who think about the world.
Right.
Who, you know, think about all of these things.
Yeah.
You know,
so. I think we're going the right way, though, because I feel like even just a couple of years ago, it wasn't like this big, not the film industry, but just representation as well.
It's really growing exponentially in every different avenue.
And I think it's great, because it's like, I mean, not, I suppose,
you know, just like this show, you know, I mean, mm-hmm. you know, I don't know how old this show is, but you know, I'm sure it's you have a lot more viewership now, and
for sure. I feel like even for this show, like, there's always not like Pakistani people on it, so even just to get more, because obviously we live in Canada, to like people who have never maybe seen you before, like, just be like, oh, this guy's Pakistani, like, now, you know what I mean? So it's just like, it's a good representation. People are like, oh, they're funny, they're nice, and they're Pakistani. So it's a nice, like, you know, it's a nice, like, way to see Pakistan. But with the good comes the bad, obviously. You've been in the industry longer, and even though you just started, I'm sure you both have heard criticism, whether it's people who don't like your work or just people who don't like you as a person. How do you both deal with, like, the rude and negative comments?
I'm pretty lucky that way, I think, you know. Okay. Yeah, I think even in the, you know, projects which haven't done well, you know, I usually get a good comment. A couple of us were sitting down the other day, and we were having this topic, and I'm like, actually completely non-political. You know, and I believe an actor or someone in this power, you know, unless that is the avenue you want to take, you know, I don't think, you know, actors should be humanitarians, they should be social workers, they should not have political views.
Okay.
You know, that's how I feel.
And that's interesting, because a lot of actors have political views, especially nowadays.
Do, and, you know, I mean, that's fine if those are your ambitions, you know, but I think, you know, because you are powerful as an actor, you know, people do listen to you, you know, people who really follow you will listen to what you say, so be careful.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I feel sometimes we're very harsh and erratic. I mean, and these days, what's going on social media, I mean, you know, everyone just, you know, they've got their thumbs are just waiting to, you know, snap at something, bite at something, follow something, and then it's gone. You know what really annoys me?
Yeah, it just disappears.
You know, there'll be this huge buzz, and then nothing will happen.
Yeah, for sure.
Then they'll be on the next thing. You know, then they'll be on the next thing. I mean, I think it's ridiculous.
Yeah. I know. So, like, I mean, just seeing, like, newspapers, and if you, like, ever read something and you hear
everything
a rumor
is tabloid. And we've been, I think, especially in Pakistan, we've been, you know, in fact, I've just, you know, this is just a realization, you know, we're so sensationalized in our breaking news.
Right.
And, you know, everything is a breaking news. Ke bhans churi ho gayi ji, gaon mein, or breaking.
Yeah.
You know, it's made all of us like that. We're like, oh no, us ladki ka dupatta gir gaya, social media pe.
Yeah.
Dude, this is not news, man. This is not stuff that we... There are much more serious issues that we should talk about.
Yeah. I think, you know what the issue is? Like, being in the media myself, obviously I'm not a part of that culture, which I'm glad about. Yeah. But
you get roped into it, right?
Yeah. There's, like, Kardashians and all these, like, main people. Even if you're living, like, internationally, you, like, care about them in a certain... Yeah. Like, it's like you don't want to, but sometimes you'll just click on something and be like...
I fail to understand. I've never watched it. You know, I've watched it, like, once or twice. I mean, I'll give it its value for entertainment. But there is no substance.
Yeah, there isn't.
You know,
yeah,
there is, I mean, no substance.
She became the youngest billionaire. I think
that's fine.
Something.
I mean, it's, you know, for a lot of girls. But I think it's such a, you know, like by the age of 25, you've grown out of it.
Mm-hmm. Well, we haven't hit 25, so we don't know.
You will. I'm telling you. You know. So.
No, I know what you mean. Yeah, but like, I feel like what I was saying.
Cartoon Network for the teenagers.
You know what? It probably is. Yeah. But even in Pakistan, so if you like read a tabloid and it says like a rumor about you, are you ever like, when did I even do that? Like, I don't even remember saying this.
Yeah, that happens. Yeah, that happens. But I've, you know, I've never responded to negative publicity.
Okay.
You know? I mean, unless it's like something really damning, which might really, you know.
Yeah, like hurt your reputation.
I think, I've always let my work speak for itself.
Right. Okay.
You know, I know when I go out in public, I get a lot of love. You know, I get appreciation for my, just my personality even, you know, or the way I've been. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I don't feel I need to prove myself.
Yeah.
You know,
I feel like sometimes
if there's some bad press, you know, I almost get defended by
other people. Yeah, because it's your fans, right? And I've seen that on your page too. Sometimes if someone writes something bad about you, then your like army of fans will be like, no, that's not true.
Yeah.
So it's kind of convenient in the sense that like,
I feel like I'm a little opposite from what he said. Like for me, I have strong beliefs in some things and I am not like, I won't shy away from saying them.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe it's because I'm not in like in the position that you are in. And I feel like maybe it'll change.
I think it's a personal choice. And a lot of people who are, you know, in my position are very vocal.
I can think of like so many names on the top of my head that are always posting about like politics and all these things. So you try to stay away from that.
You know, that's not my aim. I mean, you know, unless I have any motivation that way, I mean, that would be something else. I mean, I'm too busy trying to just work my own life to be bothered about.
Yeah.
You know. I believe in humanitarian causes. I'm very charitable, you know, so in my own way. But I'm not also boasting about those things.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's just
which I think
I
is like the best way to do it, right? I feel like with a lot of political things too, it's like such like either people.
It's more, you're just jumping onto a bandwagon that's getting publicity already,
Now you know you also have like two daughters, and with the industry, like I feel like I said, it is growing, but it still has like a sort of like a negative connotation in regards to newcomers that want to join it. People say it's like there's manipulation and there's a lot of like scandals and other things. How would you feel if your daughters told you in the future that they want to be a part of the industry?
I think if anything, if that's what they did want to do, I would support them and, you know, I'd guide them, I suppose. You know, I suppose being a part of the business, I know what the loopholes are or where the stumbling blocks are. So, you know, if anything,
wouldn't be like, no, do something else?
I don't know. I mean, when the time comes.
How old are they?
They're only 7 and 5.
Okay, so,
this time. But, I think, you know, I believe in, like, my parents were with me and, you know, I think whatever your kid wants to do, that's what you can't fight them.
For sure,
you just support them in it. So.
Yeah. Okay.
You know, I suppose if that's what they wanted to do, I'd just try and help them.
Yeah.
You know, somehow.
Do you think you'd have a bit of a reservation? Because you have seen, like, I'm sure the bad side of it at some point. You've been here for a long time. Maybe you haven't experienced it yourself. I know some of the girls that come to the show have a different point of view. But obviously,
I think it's different for women. I mean, I don't think I'd have a reservation.
Okay, that's
about
good
it.
To know. So I feel like that's like even relieving people who are watching who might want to go into the industry, because I know a lot of people's parents are like, oh no, don't do this, or don't like go to Pakistan and try to become an actor, right? There's sort of like a negative thing to it.
Well, every industry has its ups and downs, and you know, I think you're not wrong as well by saying that, it is a. It is an industry where you can get, you know, kind of driven to, you know, things like that perhaps, but you know, one has to be careful. We're all exposed to it. It's how you deal with it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I just don't think, you know, that's, you know, it's never been a belief of mine, never worked for me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so it's more of a personal choice.
Yeah. And for you, like, you got lucky because your parents were really supportive, so you didn't have that like, oh no, don't go into the Pakistani industry or the movie industry.
Actually, I did. It started with YouTube, right? So they deleted my YouTube like 3 times, told you. So it was my persistence. Like, I was I'm doing it. So I think I forced them into saying, okay.
So now they're like, okay, go do it.
So now they're like, I've already did it. To be honest, I do something and then tell them I did it. I did the movie and then told them, oh, I did a movie, by the way.
So now
they're like on board. Because you know what? Like, my mom getting calls from everybody about me congratulating her. So I think they're getting happy now.
Yeah, I mean, it's a big deal. And I'm so proud of you because it's an achievement to be like a movie with Mikal and some of the other big actors. Yeah. It's like a very good first stepping stone, I would say.
I think not everyone gets it. I think I've been extremely blessed. And like you said, it's hard to get in and all that stuff. For me, I didn't have to face anything. I think I got good production team. I got good actors. And they've been so nice to me. I didn't have to deal with any of the negativeness yet.
Yeah, for sure. And I hope you never do.
I hope so too.
Now, you know, before we go on to the game, I want you to sing for us. Did you sing of a song?
Which of the things? Kaunsa gaon? I don't know.
Just like anything that you've been liking these days.
Mm. He's been saying that.
Can like, I not? I don't think it's a bad hair day and a bad voice day.
I promise you we'll edit it out if it doesn't sound good. Just sing like two lines. Or maybe you can sing together if that makes you feel better.
Oh, you sing too?
No, you do.
I don't sing.
You
but,
too.
You should just like, sing an old one.
Oh, I could sing the one. I could sing the song that I'm performing to.
Yeah. Okay, do it.
I'm performing.
Yeah.
How'd it start? How'd it start?
I don't know.
कहानियों के एक परी हाथ ना कभी लगी आज मेरी बाहों में है ये दिल खुशी से फूल के यूं गुबार की तरह निकला मेरे हाथों से है.
Oh, you're such a cute. Okay, I honestly wasn't expecting it.
I was like, you'll be come here and say
that. Yeah, no, that was really good. I can't believe you almost didn't let me hear that. That was, that's a good song.
You should watch some YouTube videos.
Yeah,
I'll do an English one as well.
Okay, let's hear it. See,
now that we're at it.
Okay.
Hold on. Okay. I'm going to edit a little bit. I'm thinking about ओके सो जल्दी से मैं जाके लिरिक्स ले आया ताकि ठीक हो जाए. ऑलराइट, वी विल ट्राई. वेल यू ओनली नीड द लाइट व्हेन इट्स बर्निंग लो ओनली मिस द सन व्हेन इट स्टार्ट्स टू स्नो ओनली नो यू लव हर व्हेन यू लेट हर गो ओनली नो यू बीन हाई व्हेन यू फीलिंग लो ओनली हिट द रोड व्हेन यू मिसिंग होम ओनली नो यू लव हर व्हेन यू लेट हर गो.
Yay, good job.
It would have been nicer with the guitar, but yeah.
Okay.
He plays the guitar too.
Okay, wow.
Just put on the better one.
If I knew, I would have bought a guitar. I actually bought a guitar a long time ago. It's just like sitting in the corner of my room. It's a hard like thing to learn how to play.
Yeah, guitars are not easy.
Yeah, I tried, like I knew the chords, but to do them together in
like
the flow.
Three or 6 months of practice, yeah.
Yeah, and I give up after like 2 weeks.
Yeah.
So what, is that the only instrument you know, or you know more?
I know the guitar, I can play the piano as well.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah, I mean, piano not so much anymore. That's something I did in school.
Yeah.
But and guitar, I'm not great, but I can strum a few chords. I can play a few songs.
Yeah. So, okay, next time you come, we'll bring a guitar. Okay, I want to play a quick fun game with you guys. And Nayab, I hope you win this one. This one's the Urdu one, so not that one.
Okay,
like, because Nayab was telling me last time that she's like, she obviously knows Urdu. Like, you speak Urdu and stuff, but like, speaking in front of people, I guess you've gotten better at.
Yeah.
So anyways, I'm hoping Nayab wins this. Okay, so I'm going to say a word in English, and you're going to translate it for me in Urdu.
Okay.
Some of them are words, some of them are phrases.
Obviously, he's going to be great at this.
Okay, well, I'm going to, oh, you know what, we can, okay, let's just try a competition.
You know, because when we were in school in Pakistan, that used to be one of the lessons.
No way.
Yeah, translating English to Urdu and Urdu to English.
Oh, okay, so I guess you have an advantage. But then we have another Toronto slang one.
That'll definitely do this problem.
Okay, so okay, don't look at the answers.
Okay.
Okay, the first word is trees.
Draft.
Okay, have a nice day.
Acha din hoga aapka.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, okay, have a nice day. Okay, so one. Some of them are really easy because I was like, I want
to. That doesn't mean anything.
Okay, what would you say? Have
a nice day.
Have a nice day.
Acha din rahe.
Rab rakha.
That is not what I have on the paper.
What do you have?
I have acha din hai actually, yeah.
See? Yeah. Maybe it's Canadian translation.
Ours are direct translation. Okay, house.
Ghar.
Okay, are you nuts? You know this? Okay, I want a direct translation of nuts in there. What do you call nuts?
Tum Okay,
so I have akhrot. I have akhrot in there.
Akhrot is a very Pashto thing.
Yeah, it's okay.
But akhrot is akhrot
badam? Akhrot is yum, no.
Akhrot no, akhrot is the
isn't
seed.
It's akhrot walnut.
Akhrot is the seed. Yeah, walnut.
Okay, yeah. I have no idea. Okay, rabbit.
Khargosh.
What are you doing?
I'm letting her win, yeah.
Yeah, sure. Okay.
I'm cool. The gentleman.
Cool man.
Cool man?
Yeah.
Sardi.
direct translation.
Thand.
Thanda banda.
I have thanda aadmi, I'll give you that one. Okay.
Thanda banda sounds nice.
Yeah, it does sound nicer. I missed you so much.
Main tumhe bahut miss kar rahi hu.
Tum yaad
kar rahi hu.
Okay, those are both good. I had a really good one. I wrote, mujhe aapki bahut kami mehsoos
ho rahi hai. Oh, oh, miss kar
raha hai. That's what I got online.
That's Google Translate. Movie dialogues.
Yeah. Okay, go straight and then turn right and left.
आगे जाके फिर left. आगे जाके उल्टे हाथ होके सीधे हाथ हो जाना.
Okay.
Close enough.
I have सीधे जाकर दाएं और बाएं मिल जाएं.
दाएं और बाएं.
Okay.
I don't even know my दाएं and बाएं.
Yeah, I think this is दाएं and this is
बाएं. Right, left.
दाएं and
बाएं. Which one is दाएं?
दाएं, बाएं.
Yeah, I have no idea. Okay, one moment, please.
एक मिनट.
Minute is an English word.
एक.
एक second. एक.
Second भी है.
एक.
एक. एक लम्हा
मिनट
एक लम्हा दो
और लम्हा
एक लम्हा
ओके आई थिंक शी गेट्स दिस वन
आई
हैव बिकॉज़ दिस इज वेरी लाइक द यू नो व्हेन यू कॉल समवन दे देयर इज अ रिंगटोन इट सेज बराए मेहरबानी कुछ देर इंतजार
करें कुछ देर इंतजार करें एक मिनट दे थोड़ी देर इंतजार करें
या ओके नाउ यू आर विनिंग ओके फैन लाइक द सीलिंग फैन यस
टर्बो
स्कल
स्कल brain.
Dimag?
No, dimag is brain.
Khopri.
Yes. That's a hard one. Gorilla. I didn't know this one until gorilla. Today.
Monkey.
Bandar?
Bandar.
No. Bandar? Gorilla? Gorilla?
I know bandar is monkey, so gorilla is something else. It starts with a B.
Gorilla.
Balu?
No, that's a bear. That's a bear.
Ba.
Don't know.
No, you don't know. Okay, I think it's I don't know how to say it, but bun manas or something like
what?
That.
What? I've never heard
it's
that.
I confirmed it. That's how you. It's like bun and then man, yeah.
What is that?
Bun I know viewers are gonna be seeing this. Like they all suck.
I've
don't
never
know what we do.
Heard that before.
Okay, okay. Apple.
Same.
Same.
Yeah. Elbow.
Goni.
Goni.
breath.
Sans.
Yeah. Okra, like the vegetable.
Bindi.
Yes.
Vomit.
Ulti.
Pants.
Pantaloon.
okay, last one. Oh no, second last one. Face.
Chehra.
Yeah, but okay. It's the same. Yeah. Okay, last one is easy, but iron.
Istri.
Okay, that's a very even on that one.
I feel like Nayab won a lot of
times.
Yeah, she might have won. Okay, Nayab won. I was hoping for you to win. I'll give you like a coffee. okay, so end it off. We wanted to do something because I actually thought Nayab was not going to win. I'm going to be completely honest.
Okay.
So I was like, me and Nayab will do something for you.
Okay, okay.
We're both
okay.
From Toronto and you're
okay.
Obviously new here.
Okay.
We have a lot of slang here.
Right.
So it's like words that me and Nayab probably don't even say all the time. But we're going to give you a word and say it in a sentence and you're gonna guess.
Okay.
So we'll go like one by one. Okay. So you can start the first one.
Okay. Wagwan.
What?
Wagwan.
Wagwan?
Yes. So say it in a sentence.
What do you want?
Okay. Wagwan, dude.
What's up, dude?
Yeah, okay. That one was like easy one. Okay, so second
Wagwan?
One.
Wagwan?
Yeah, that's a thing. So like people will call to them and be like, Wagwan.
Oh, I like this second one.
Okay, so second
it's
one
like
is...
Kiddan.
Yeah, basically, Wagwan.
Yeah, yeah, so mandem. So I'm trying to link the mandems.
The mandems.
Yeah.
I'm linking. He won't know what link is.
Friends.
Oh. Friends. Group of friends.
Yeah.
Group of friends?
Oh, you're doing pretty good. Okay. Okay.
I don't know. I don't even know this one. So you do. That.
Okay. So I hope I'm saying it right, but it's called Kawal.
Kawal.
And it's like they made you pay $50 for a jacket. I bought it for $25. You got Kawaled.
There's you got skanked.
Yeah.
Tricking someone.
Trick.
Okay.
Yeah.
Bones.
Bones.
I need 3 bones.
For tic tac toe.
3 bones?
No, that's a TTC.
Pencils?
No, bones. I need three bones
for a coffee.
Yeah.
3 bones? Like a dollar?
It's like money.
Yeah.
I didn't know how to do that.
You better memorize these and say it to your friends in Pakistan.
I'll give you this coffee.
Okay, you say the next one. Fawad.
Fawad.
Fawad?
Not your friend Fawad. Fawad.
Like, who's Fawad into my house tonight?
Who's coming?
Yeah. See, the context is like kind of giving it away.
Yeah.
If you heard these like words on a normal basis,
yeah, you'd be like,
you wouldn't know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Let's just go to nice. So nice that.
Nice that.
Yeah.
No.
Nice. You're being stupid. Nice. Stop.
Stop.
Yes.
Okay. How about gassed?
So this is one we use a lot in Canada.
Gassed. Yeah. Gassed. Yeah. Yeah. And the last one.
Use it in a phrase.
Gassed. I'm so gassed. What? No.
Yeah. I'm so gassed. No. Like, or someone complimented.
Stop being gassed. You're not that good looking.
You need to go to the bathroom.
It has nothing to do with the
washing. You got gas?
Yeah.
You've been having too many curries.
Okay, another, to make it easier, we also say boosted.
Boosted.
So, like, you're like, you're so boosted.
You're gas boosted.
You don't know?
It means hyped.
Yeah.
Like I feel gas, like, I feel okay. Great.
Oh, yeah. Okay. It's when you feel confident.
You said the opposite.
So, someone's like, oh, you have nice hair, and you're like, you're going to be like, I'm gas.
Gas.
Yeah.
No, I don't think I'd ever say that.
I think you'll know this last one.
Okay, so last one's like a common
you'll
one,
know
but
this
YOLO.
One. YOLO.
YOLO. You only live once?
Yes!
That's what I believe in.
Okay, yeah, that was the end of
See?
It.
See, that was pretty good.
You're pretty good.
You just didn't get one, right?
We helped you out.
Or two.
Yeah, I feel like the context really helped. Because when you, and it's funny because for me and Ayab, sometimes we'll hear people talking and you don't notice it's slang.
Well, right.
So when I, like, yeah, so I had someone send me this list and some of them, I was like, oh, I say these words and you don't even realize that you're saying them. Yeah. Especially gassed.
Gassed.
That's like a big one here.
You should really use that too much.
Mandem.
Yeah.
There's an American one that I just learned. It's called deadass.
Yeah, deadass.
We're starting to use it. It means like, seriously.
Yeah. If you're like, are you deadass? It means like, are you serious?
Are you serious? You take these back to Pakistan.
Yeah, keep that copy and use it with all your celebrity friends and just like confuse.
So Wagwan, Kowal, Bones, Defaz. Defaz?
Is that what it says?
Defaz.
We didn't ask you that one.
Oh yeah, we skipped it.
We didn't even know that one.
Defaz.
Yeah, it's okay. You can take it home. You'll take it home.
Knees. Nice.
Maybe we're even pronouncing it wrong.
I know. I know.
I don't even know these.
Some of these are not common. Some of them are really common.
We're too old for them.
You just made it all up.
Okay, but thank you so much for coming here today. I had a lot of fun talking to you guys.
Likewise.
Good luck for the Hum TV Award.
Thank you.
Hopefully you don't freeze on stage. I'll be in the crowd just watching. Like, I hope he doesn't just blank out.